Morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking.
I bought a
I bought a flank steak, okay? And it's about 2 1/3 pounds, okay? Just letting you know how much I'm making. Okay, what I'm making, and I hope you join me today, we're gonna make a marinade, and it's called Marinated Flank Steak with a North African Marinade, okay? So it sounds really good. I've been reading it. So let's get started. Let me get my apron on and we'll get started on this. Now we want 1 cup of finely chopped onions. I don't know if this is going to give me a cup. If it doesn't, I'll be using some red onions because I ran out of golden onions. But we'll see. I need a measuring cup to do this. Okay. And the reason I gave you the weight so you know how much I'm making, so if you make it, you'll know the size meat to go with. When they say finely chopped, it's very close to being minced. Just another term for it. So you get the flavors. The meat can absorb the flavors. They also say because of the kind of cut this meat is, you can't cook it too long because if you do, it will dry out and it doesn't have much fat on it. It has some marbling in it, but you don't want it so dry that you just lose all the flavor in it. So they do recommend that you're gonna have to eat it a little on the it's on the other page. Anyway, they recommend don't overcook it, okay? Because we're gonna be grilling it tomorrow. I think it'll go excellent with the I have some leftover glazed radishes with Litz potatoes, which is delicious, by the way. I didn't think it was going to turn out that good, and it really, really came out quite nice. I just like the whole way the flowers and the radishes flavors came together. The radishes weren't that strong. You would think that they would have been, but they really weren't that strong. I expected them to be just overpowering the potatoes, but they did not. They just mellowed out so nicely. But I think it'll go good with this tomorrow. take us to finely chop fresh ginger. They want 1.5 tablespoons. Okay. That all in, it's about a tablespoon and a half. Yep, that's just about 1.5, maybe just a hair more. All right, they want a tablespoon of minced garlic. Okay. They want a half a cup of olive oil. Now they want 6 tablespoons of fresh lemon juice. Okay. Lemon juice. Oh, here it is. I already canned lemon juice. I already have it. Canning lemon juice like this is really nifty. But I always smell everything I can. That. Now they want 2 tablespoons of soy sauce. They want a tablespoon of dry sherry. When you cook some of these recipes, you have to have liquor. I don't always drink it. I rarely drink it, but I do cook it a lot. All right, you want 1/4 of a cup of fresh cilantro. 1/4 of a cup is 4 tablespoons. Divide that and be, I'm gonna wipe this off. So that'd be a tablespoon. You're using dry cilantro. It will be 1 tablespoon and 1 teaspoon. Okay. You're using fresh, it's only 1/4 of a cup, but I don't have that, so I had to break it down. When you use dry, it's 1/3 of whatever you have. That's why I said it'll be 1 tablespoon and 1 teaspoon. To give you the right ratio. Okay. They want 1 tablespoon of chili powder. See all the ingredients? Doesn't it sound like it's going to be good? I mean, we can hear all the seasonings coming in. They really sound good, the combination. All right, they want 1 tablespoon of cumin. One teaspoon of turmeric. One teaspoon of dry Marinade, that's all I've got left in my bottle, so that's it. get some more of that. 2 teaspoons. Well, first, let's get our salt. We need 2 teaspoons of salt. They want 2 teaspoons of a hot sauce. I am just going to loot the only one I have in the house, Louisiana hot sauce, so I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of that. They don't tell you which one to get, they just say a hot sauce. And they want 1 teaspoon of black pepper ground. Okay, let me get some paper towels. See the marbling? Isn't that beautiful? I grew up with a lot of marbling in our meat. And now they've done the cattle, keep it on the lean side now. Keep it in the refrigerator in a smaller area. Only because my refrigerator is so packed with food. Sometimes I just run out of room. But I can put this in here. At least I hope it fits. Oh, good. Now, if you don't want to cook this tomorrow, you can leave it. They say up to 7 days, okay? What I will do is turn it over every couple of hours. Just let it marinate in there.
And I think it'll be all right.
I can't wait to have this with the radishes and those potatoes. I have some left over, so I'm going to definitely serve it with this. Into the refrigerator, but remember, if you can't get to it the next day, you have up to 7 days.
That's the end of the video. Sorry. Take care.